So, program for today, threshold swim. After we already did a threshold run session in the morning, which was 4x2k and 6x1k. And now we do...
I'm just listening.
And now we do three times this whole set. 400, 300, 200, 100 yards. It's a 25-yard pool. And all at 115 per 100 exit. And all at about threshold. Gonna measure lactate after every set. The last one maybe with pedals. And yeah, Paulina is with us today again to support us and film again. Hey guys, first of all, sorry for the noisy background, but it's basically the only place here which is still quite lightful, as our flat here in St. George is quite dark. Yeah, Nico and me are now in St. George. To be honest with you, yeah, I wanted to do a little more videos and vlogging from Park City, but yeah, that's how it is when you are a pro triathlete and not a pro YouTuber. Yeah, I just was really focused training, and I think that's okay. This is still my main job, and I try to take you along as much as I can on YouTube, but yeah, we were training really well, and just wasn't fitting in as much. And it's definitely easier when you have the videographers like Holy or Tom around doing the filming for you. They're still doing the cutting though, so or like Holy doing the cutting of this video, so thanks for that for now. And yeah, to give a quick summary of the training camp in Park City, it was definitely a really, really good camp. Yeah, I can say it was actually my best ever camp, especially considering training on over 2000 meter altitude, sleeping on 2120 meter. I hope it will work out well for the race. I got a lot of questions about the day coming down from altitude before the race. We are down now since Friday. The race is in this week on Saturday, so yeah, we came down 8 days before. And yeah, last year after my first altitude camp, I did a race right off altitude, so like 2 days later, which was Challenge Gran Canaria, which didn't go well. So after that we made the conclusion racing right off altitude is not working for me, and we're going like last year, yeah, 4 to 5 weeks after my first altitude camp. I had Challenge St. Pölten, which was going really well, and I definitely had a kind of altitude boost. And yeah, for Livigno last year, where I was training for 3 weeks, we were also going the safe option of 3 weeks. But this year, after Sierra Nevada, I did one race, which was yeah, not so important for me, which was the Olympic distance in Buschütten. But luckily, this was going really, really well, and I definitely had an altitude boost there 1 week after 1 week coming off from altitude in Sierra Nevada. And after that, I was actually checking my training results from the year before when I came down from Livigno 1 week after coming down from altitude, and there they were also like really good. So I was thinking for the best altitude boost, it might be a good idea to really get down like 1 week before. And I am actually quite optimistic this will work. We will see this Saturday. And of course, apart from that, everything else still has to go well. Like, for of course, no mechanical, and also the race hopefully plays into my cards. But I'm definitely quite optimistic. I will definitely make another video, at least a short pre-race interview, just give a few words about the race, which will still come out this week before the race, where we'll talk more about that. But right now, the camp was going really well. Park City is definitely, just to give you a few numbers about the camp, we were there for exactly 30 days, and I swam in total 96 kilometers, most of that in a 25 yard pool. Actually all of that, we only one time we were swimming in a lake, but it's okay. Especially for altitude, I think it's not too bad to just swim in like a shorter pool. For long term, I wouldn't like it. I don't think it's the best to get better in a, well, it's, don't think it will work well to get better in a 25 yard pool if you swim there all the time. So I'm pretty privileged living in Nuremberg, training in a 50 meter pool. 96 kilometer, 24 hour and 54 minute. Cycling was just over 2000 kilometer, 2015 kilometer to be exact, in 61 hours. Definitely quite some volume, but also a lot of quality and an altitude. So running was 319 kilometer and 23 hours and 5 minutes. So it was definitely a really good training camp. I hope I will benefit from it. Just wanted to give you this update and this video. I hope you still enjoyed it. Of course, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And Jana is coming tomorrow, actually, to St. George, supporting me. Really happy about that. Also, didn't see her in 2 months, so really looking forward and excited. And she can also do some filming, definitely, and help me a bit with that. So. Yeah, we're gonna get one more video up before the race, and then of course the race recap from the World Championship on Saturday. So thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.